Hello, my name is James Bach. I'm the world's greatest photographer. Today I'm going to talk to you about how to pick out the SLR that is best for your photographic needs. First thing you want to look at is price, the price of the camera, whether you'll be able to afford it in your budget or not. The second thing you want to look at is to make sure the quality of the images is good enough. So check online. There are many pictures of photos from different kinds of cameras on the internet. Third thing is to make sure the camera is not too heavy. You want a camera that will not weigh you down too much, that's easy to use, that you can walk around with, and not have to worry about, like I said, weighing you down. For me, the choice was choose the Nikon D60. Let me show you. I'm not sure if you can see that, but it says D60 there, the silver part. This camera is a great camera. It is the one that I use for digital work for now. Might upgrade someday if I find one that's better, or if this becomes too obsolete and better pictures can be made for something else that's newer. Again, this camera is easy to use, like the D40 was, except this one allows you to edit images in the camera, which the D40 didn't, I don't think. The D60 is a 10.2 megapixel camera, which is all I really need for photographing stuff, because I'm not photographing a the photographs that I'll be making are not really large. They're gonna be 8x10 inch. Now, if you want to make a large print, like a 3 foot by 4 foot or something, let's say, you might want a better camera, because more megapixels equals less pixels than you can see, and when you shoot a big picture like that, shoot from a large image size. But so 10.2 is good enough to produce a picture on an 8x10. When I say 8x10, I don't mean 8 foot by 10 foot. What I mean is 8 inch by 10 inch, or 8.5 by 11, or you can go all the way up to 9.5 figures would look good. But this is a great camera, and I highly would recommend it, except everywhere I look now for this thing, I can't find it. They've switched to the D5000 or D7000 for some reason. I bought this one from Best Buy, so they might still sell it at Best Buy. I don't know. But the higher the megapixel, again, I said before, the better the images, the less pixels you can see at if the picture is big, blown up, you know, like, I don't know. Like I said, or it's blown to like huge size, like anything above like 1.5 feet, I think, be considered big enough to fall under that category. And what I mean by 1.5 feet is, I mean 1.5 feet by 1.5 feet, not 1.5 feet by 10 inches. But anyway, enough said. I confused myself if I kept on that subject, so yeah. And the D60 that I bought was cheap enough, hitting the budget range that I needed. So anyway, you know, buy the camera that you want to buy and make sure that the pictures that it takes are high enough quality. I went to Nikon Cypher Time. I was like, I went there, looked at pictures. Now these are pictures that they're trying to use to sell their camera. I don't have any to show right now, maybe some other time, then somehow incorporate it into the movie. But there's a picture. And the D3X is not meant for like high speed, and by high speed I mean it's not good for taking pictures of moving objects. So, and the D3X, there's a picture on the Nikon website of the D3X, just not of the D3X, but of a car moving, taken by the D3X. And I noticed that around the wheels, where the tire hits the wheel, it was all pixelated. And I was like, why would they do that? And obviously the car was moving fast, or fast enough that it pixelated the thing. And I don't understand that picture, but anyway, there's another picture on there of a car parked, and some looks like some Venetian or French city, I don't know, some foreign city over there in Europe. And the car's parked there in front, out by some tables. Okay, but I saw a lot of pixelation in that picture. on all the lines in all the, like, in the car. The lines are pixelated. They didn't look straight. They look like they're jagged, like, good. I'm not sure you can see that, but it's like, let me see if I can do it. It's like that kind of thing. And then there's this other, and then this other spot in the picture on the ground, it looks pixelated kind of like that too, where, and every line looks pixelated almost. Anyway, yeah, I would not buy the D3X if they were the last camera on Earth, because the Nikon website does not put forth good enough image, or that's how I feel about it. Maybe you'll feel differently, but and the D3X is the most expensive camera so far. So why are they? It's like people just want the camera. It's got 24.5 megapixels. They don't care about the quality of the image. It's like, I don't know, it just seems stupid to me. But it's just me. So yeah, D3X. You can look at it if you want to. Just go to Nikon's website and click on it. Find it first. If you want to see those images. Anyway, I'm going to get off. But I highly recommend you get a camera that is good, that works good, that produces good images, that is cheap enough for you to afford, that's light enough, easy enough to use, and that's about it.